Hi, welcome back to the full stack development with Angular and Spring MVC. My name is Bhushan. In this video, we will be creating a Maven project and we will add all the dependencies to our application and we will create packages and we will set up our database. By the end of this video, we will be set up our application and we are ready to create an API. So let's get started. I'm using an Eclipse IDE for the development. You can use any other IDEs like Spring Toolsuit or IntelliJ IDEA or NetBeans IDE. So if you are using the Eclipse to create a Maven project, go to File, click on New and choose Maven project. Click on this Create a Simple Project, skip Archetype selection and click Next. Give a group ID com.bhushansirigur. Artifact ID, I'm gonna call this Book API. Click Finish. This will create a Maven project. This will take a few seconds to create an application. And once it is done, double click on the Book API project and double click on the pom.xml. Inside the pom.xml, we will be adding all the dependencies. In interest of time, I have already copied all the dependencies to our clipboard, so I'll paste it inside the pom.xml. If you look at this pom.xml, there is nothing to XML because on above every dependency, I have nicely commented out that why we are using that dependency. For example, this is for Spring dependency, and this is for Spring ORM, this is for Hibernate, and this is for C3P0 for connection pooling, and this is for MySQL connector. Like that, I have nicely commented out that why we are using that dependency. So by looking that comments, you can easily understand there is nothing to explain in this pom.xml. Once you add the dependencies to this pom.xml, that's it. You're never going to touch this pom.xml ever again. So once you added the dependencies, save this, and you need to update the project. So right click on the project and go to the Maven and click on the update project and click OK. This will download all the dependencies that we have specified in this file. If you go to the properties of the project and if you go to the Java build path and in the Maven dependencies, you can find all the dependencies that I have downloaded or the jar files that I have downloaded. And now let's create a packages for our project. So inside the source main Java, right click, create a new package. We're going to create a 5 packages. One is for configuration and one is for controller and one is for DAO and model and service. So let's go ahead and create the packages. com.bhushansirigur.spring.config. This package holds the configuration for Spring and Hibernate. Click Finish. Copy this and paste it. And I'm changing this to DAO instead of configuration. And I'll change this to controller. Model and service. Okay, now we have created 5 packages and we have to create one more file, which is a property file. So inside the source main resources, create a file, choose other and filter for file, choose the file which is inside the general folder and click next and give a file name db.properties. Click Finish. All right, now we have to create a database for our API. I'm going to use a MySQL database for this API. You can use any other databases you want. So I'm going to use a MySQL workbench. So open the MySQL workbench. So inside this, I'm going to create a database. Create database. And the database name, in this case, it's Book API. execute the command and refresh the section, you can see the book API. So we have created this database. In order to use this database, or in order to select this database, you need to use command, use the database name. In this case, it's a book API. Execute the command. The book API is selected. That's it. We are not going to create a database tables, because the database tables will be created by Hibernate. So we just create a database in this case. So minimize this. All right, we have created the Maven project and created a packages, and also we created a property file. We also set up our database. So in the next video, we will start writing a code for our API. In the next video, inside the configuration package, we are going to create a few classes and we will configure the Spring and Hibernate. We'll see you in the next video.